Girls, our next topic is production possibility curve. What do you mean by possibility? The ability, isn't it? So we can discuss the problem of choice of relatively scarce product, isn't it? We have studied already, human wants are unlimited, but the resources are limited. So with the limited resources, we are satisfying our wants with the help of choice. The third definition, scarcity definition, Lionel Robbins. Scarce definition talks about the choice making, isn't it? So, with the help of a geometric device, we can illustrate how with the limited resources, we can choose our choice. It is also known as production possibility curve. All production possibility frontier. The other name is production possibility frontier. And it shows the menu of choice. So, resources limited. Wants unlimited. Thus it comes the choice, isn't it? So with the limited resources, how can we satisfy our wants? We are going to study in the help of production possibility curve with basic assumptions. I already told you assumptions, hypothetical, that is assumptions. So what are the assumptions of production possibility curve? If you want to give a geographic or a geometric diagram, you should have some assumptions. So what are the assumptions of production possibility curve? If you want to draw a production possibility curve, what are the things should be there? First one, time. It does not change. The time period, does not change, it should be remains same throughout the curve. If you want to draw a curve of production possibility, throughout the curve, the time does not change. Time should be stable, static. And then techniques are fixed. There should be no changes in the techniques. I already told you in economics, set is variables, that is the other things are being equal is an assumption. The same way, here also we have some assumptions. The time should not change, technique should not change, and full employment in the economy. There is no unemployment, all the people are employed. Everybody is getting income, everybody is getting job and other things. And in the choice, we have only two commodities or two goods. While we are drawing the production possibility curve, the curve shows only the two goods. And resources are fully mobile. It can move from one place to another place without any restriction. So resources of production are fully movable, mobile. And then factor of productions are given in the quantity as well as the quality. Both quantity and quality. How many and at what rate, in what kind, everything will be decided, fixed. Law of diminishing marginal returns operate. These are the seven assumptions to draw the production possibility curve. For the choice, we have only two goods. We are not going to picking up. We are going to compare with the help of production possibility curve. So, every production possibility curve is based on these assumptions only. If any assumptions are omitted or neglected, production possibility curve will not function. And just remind that we are going to produce two things. I already told you production of possibility curve. We have only two goods. Now let me tell you what are the two goods, how we are going to utilize. Before that, I'll give you one example. If you understand the example, you can understand the production possibility curve easily. You have 100 rupees in your tank. You are going to purchase two things. That is two goods. What are the two goods? One is fruits. The another one is what we can keep. The another one, notebooks, notes. The cost of an apple. The fruit you are going to buy is apple. The cost of an apple is rupees 10. The cost of a note is rupees 25 or 20. Just imagine. Now, you have to choose. Either you are going to buy more notes and less apples, or less notebooks and more apples. For example, first choice, apples, notes, 10 rupees, 20 rupees. If you buy 4 apples, 40 rupees, you can buy only 3 notebooks, that is 60 rupees. Choice, you are going to give 10, you can buy only 2. Now you want to less. You can buy 4, isn't it? 3 you can buy. Now you are going to give less importance to this. You can give more importance. So, from this what you have understand, you can either choose or give preference to one good, or else you have to give preference to another one. Any one good should be given preference. We cannot give equal importance to both, isn't it? So, the same is production possibility curve. Now, they have given two things. One is food, the another one is cars. Here production possibility. Food in tons. This is in numbers. Isn't it? Now, if you want to give importance to, if you are going to utilize all the resources and you want to produce only cars, you cannot give an importance to food. And you can produce 25 cars. The resources you are utilizing. Resources fully used or utilized. Used full. With the help of the resources, given resources, you can produce only 25 cars. You can't produce food. Now, you want to divide the resources. You need to produce good food also. So from the resources you are allocating or allotting some resources for the food production. You are producing 100 tons but you can produce only 23 cars because the cost of 2 cars is utilized for the production of food. Now the third possibility. You need more food. So you are going to give much importance to food. Then automatically the resources given for car will be comes down. Further you are increasing the production of food. Then the production of car will be go down. Isn't it? If you utilize the resources for one thing, the another will not be get choice. So from this table you can understand, if you want to use the resources fully and if you want to do the production, either you have to give the preference for food or cars. If you concentrate on food, the production of cars will be less. If you want to give much importance to cars, then you can't produce food. Now, this table can be drawn as a diagram. Production possibility curve. With the help of this, I am going to draw the production possibility curve. X, Y, don't forget girls, whenever you are drawing, you are doing the drawing, you have to draw and you have to write what should be mentioned in the x-axis and also in the y-axis. Here food production, here production of car or car production. In the x-axis I have taken food, the y-axis I have taken car productions in the numbers. Number of cars, food production in tons. Okay, now 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600. Here, I am going to draw the numbers of cars. Now tell me, based on your diagram, in the 0% food production, we have 25% of car. So this is the first column. Here x axis 0, y axis 25. And the second one, x axis 100, y axis 23. So 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. So 23 with 100. Isn't it? The food production is 100. And the car production is 23. Then with the third column, 20, 200. Fourth one, 15, 300. And then 8, 6, 7, 8, 9. 8, 400. And then 500. Now, draw the production possibility curve. This is the production possibility curve. This is the point P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, P6. Production possibility. Now, with the resources, you can produce the goods up to this. Beyond, if we write P7 one point, we cannot produce goods. Why? Because we don't have any resources. How can you produce? With the limited resources, it is possible to produce only this. We can't produce P7. So it is not possible to produce. If you keep a point outside of the curve, it is not possible. Why? Because there is no resources. We have only limited resources. With the help of this resources, we can produce up to this. We can't produce beyond this. But at the same time, just think that, keep P alone. Just think that if you want to P7, if you are going to produce P7 point, you can produce. It is possible to produce this point because with the limited resources only, but here the resources are not fully employed. Resources are excess or not fully employed, isn't it? Fully used. You have used only less number of resources. We have resources up to this. So, beyond the resources, you cannot produce. Within the resources, you can produce. But it is, the resources are not entirely utilized or fully used. So, this is waste to produce P7 point. Now, do you understand, girls? Though this point we cannot attain, we cannot get this point. This point you can get, but the resources are not fully used. This is production possibility curve. And then, shift in production possibility. PPC means production possibility curve. When did the shift? First, we have drawn a possibility curve, isn't it? Let me draw one production possibility curve. So, I have the resources with the help of OE resources, OE and OA level resources. I am producing the production, the curve, AE curve. Now, I have got more resources. The supply of the resources or the supply of the raw materials. supply of the factor of production has been increased. இப்போ நாங்க காரும் ஃபுட்டும் ப்ரொடியூஸ் பண்ணும்போது என்கிட்ட 100 பேர் தான் வேலையாள் இருந்தாங்க. இப்போ எனக்கு 150 பேர் கிடைச்சிட்டாங்க. என்னுடைய இன்வெஸ்ட்மெண்ட் கூடிச்சாங்க. நான் 10 கோடி தான் முதலீடு போட்டேன். இப்போ என் கையில 15 கோடி இருக்கு. ஸோ ஐ கேன் இன்வெஸ்ட், ஐ கேன் எம்ப்ளாய் மோர் பீப்புள். அப்போ இஃப் த ரிசோர்ஸஸ் இன்க்ரீஸ், த சப்ளை ஆஃப் த ரிசோர்ஸஸ் இன்க்ரீஸ், தேர் வில் பி அ இன்க்ரீஸ் இன் த ப்ரொடக்ஷன் பாசிபிலிட்டி கர்வ். Isn't it girls? Anga P7 point la, we have no resources nu sonna, so you cannot attain the point P appdinu sonna, but you can attain the point P7, but you are utilizing only less resources, balance resources are there. Ipo if you want to have a shift in the possibility curve, what should we need? We need more resources. If the supply of the resources increased, there will be an increased or shift in the possibility curve from A1 to E1. Do you understand? This is the increase in the supply of resources. That is increase in the supply of resources. Increase in the supply of resources bring the shift, upward shift in the production possibility curve. Do you understand girls? Here I told, because we have limited resources, we cannot attain. There is no resources. If we have the resources, there will be a shift in the production possibility curve. And state of technology, technology improvement, whatever it may be, there will be a changes in the shift in the production possibility curve. What is the use of the production possibility curve? Why do we need to study this production possibility curve? It is used for the analytical purposes. What are they? First one, the problem of choice. Uses of first one, the problem of choice. With the help of the production possibility curve, we can relate the allocation of the resources, isn't it? Because the problem of choice arises because of the given limit resources and unlimited wants. Choice ingra vaartha eppada varudhu namakku? Choice ingra vaartha eppa varum? When the problem arises, we have limited time or limited resources, but we have unlimited wants. And the time la dhaan choice ingra problem varum. So the allocation of resources between the goods for the higher income group and the lower income group and the goods for the defense and civilization, idu ellame we can allocate with the problem of choice. With the help of this PPC, we can allocate the resources. What do you mean by that? Namakitta ipo, for example, இந்த பீரியட்ல, பேண்டமிக் பீரியட்ல, கொரோனா பீரியட்ல, த கவர்மெண்ட் ஹேஸ் ஒன்லி த ரிசோர்சஸ் தட் அவங்க கிட்ட ஒரு 10 crore மட்டும்தான் இருக்குன்னு வச்சுக்கோயே. தே ஹாவ் டூ சாய்ஸ், எய்தர் தே ஹாவ் டு கிவ் த ஃபுட், ஃப்ரீ ஃபுட் டு ஆல் த பீப்புள் ஹூ ஆர் சஃபரிங் ஃப்ரம் அன்எம்ப்ளாய்மெண்ட் அண்ட் அதர்ஸ், ஆர் எல்ஸ்
they have to give money to the citizen, those who are living in Tamil Nadu. So they have the resources with limited 10 crore. They have choice. Either they are going to provide food for the people, or they are going to allocate money, give money for the people. So they have to choose which is better than, or which is better between the two. Illaya, the rendu vishayathula edhu kudutha all the people will satisfy, or all the people will benefited appadingiradha paakom. So the production possibility curve help us to allocate resources. It help. What should be given more importance? Which should be given more importance? And the second one, the notion of scarcity. The idea of scarcity, the view of scarcity. Notion means view, idea, opinion. That is the view of scarcity. Already we have explained the view on scarcity, isn't it, with the help of production possibility curve. So with the help of that one, with a limited amount or limited resource, how can we use with a technology in the best way? If we are using the IT industries, even the computers are used. இப்ப நான் சொன்ன முதல்ல சொன்ன ப்ராப்ளத்திலே பாருண்டா, எவ்ரி திங் இஸ் என்ரோல்ட் இன் சிஸ்டம். வி ஹவ் ரேஷன் கார்டு வந்து இந்த ஃபார்ம் ஆஃப் கார்டு, ஜஸ்ட் லைக் ஏடிஎம், இசன்ட் இட்? ஸோ இஃப் யூ ஹவ் ஜஸ்ட் ஸ்வைப் அ கார்டு, யூ வில் நோ வாட் ஆர் த திங்ஸ் யூ கேன் பை இன் த ரேஷன் ஷாப். எவ்ரி திங் இஸ் என்ரோல்டு. ஸோ with the help of the limited resources, we are using the technology. With the help of that, they will see how many people are enjoying the benefit of the ration shop. They can get the data easily, isn't it? So from the data, they will allocate the resources. So to you, the notion of scarcity help us to improve in the technology. So it reflects the constraints imposed by the elements of economic scarcity. And the third one, solution to the central problems. Another uses solution to central problems. The central problems of an economy can be explained with the help of PPC, that is, what to produce, involve the decision regarding the choice of location on the production possibility curve. The previous video I told, isn't it? What to produce, how to produce, whom to produce, that is the basic problem of economy. So those economic problem can be solved easily with the help of PPC, production possibility curve. So a combination production represented by any point inside the PPC indicates the economy is using insufficient methods of production and inefficient combination of resources. So already I told you, if they are using the resources in the inside the production possibility curve, means they are not using the resources in an efficient manner. Some of the resources are unused. So we can get the idea. Then they can increase their production and allocating the resources. So the basic problem of economics, what to produce, how to produce and whom to produce, is solved only by the calculation of BPC. With this, we come to the end of the lesson. First chapter, girls. I have completed the first chapter. go through the lesson. If you have any doubt, you can ask me through my personal WhatsApp number. Read the lesson. Only then you can answer the questions clearly. Because one word questions will be asked only from the inside of the book. So each and every line should be read. Read the lesson. Get a clear idea. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Thank you, girls.